Hey everyone, today I want to talk about what I feel Nintendo could do to make the Nintendo Switch online app the perfect version of itself, or as close to perfection as it can possibly become. Because I do think, with some work and with some additional features, the Nintendo Switch online app could actually be quite brilliant. And I know that sounds weird coming from my mouth. In fact, I've produced two videos recently and probably five or six videos total talking about the app and my worries about it and my fears and how my fears were realized and how critical I am and how I want people to go to the feedback section on the app itself and give Nintendo some constructive criticism to them so they can, fix the app. But I want to take an approach here where the app becomes something I actually look forward to using on a daily basis. And hopefully my ideas for this app will make you guys want to use it on a daily basis as well. Now, I should note that in talking about the way that this app can perfect itself, it's not going to be able to do something like suddenly run on the Switch itself. We're gonna forget about it running natively on the Switch. We're gonna forget about native voice chat on the Switch. I feel like that boat has sailed, and if you actually look at the design of the Switch hardware, it kind of seems like it leans towards the idea that they never intended for voice chat to be native. So we're just gonna allow that boat to sail off into the sunset, and it's just something I'm gonna have to accept. Even if I think there has to be a better way to splice audio together. So let's just hop right into the apps itself and what I like about it, because I spent a lot of time criticizing it, but let's look at the things I like. I have mentioned briefly in the past that the companion aspects of the app are brilliant, but that's kind of where I left it. I didn't really dive deep into it. Well, now that I have the app and I've used it myself and I've been using it with Splatoon 2 and I've thoroughly have enjoyed using the Splatnet 2 portion of the app, I wanted to explain where I think the app has gone right. One, I like the idea that there are sub-apps within the main application. A lot of games release their own companion apps, and that's great. But at one point on my phone, between my Xbox One, PlayStation 4, or PlayStation 4, I hope to have, I don't have it yet, PC and all the stuff, all the various games I've played, at one point on my phone, I had something like 40 or 50 different companion apps for different games. And it's not that I'm upset that I have that many companion apps. It means, hey, I'm playing a wide variety of games, but it takes up a lot of space on my phone, and I know you can organize it in the folders, but it's really nice for a single platform to have those companion apps for the games on that platform under a single application. And we'll see long haul if the size of the app is going to significantly increase, or if this is all just going to be like a gateway to an online server, whatever the case may be. I really like the idea of sub apps within a main app for a single platform. I think that's just a smart idea, and it's something I think Nintendo can actually expand on. So one thing I would like to see them do with this application is allow third parties and allow indie developers to also release companion sub apps on the Nintendo Switch Online app. Now, I don't know if they have plans for this. I don't know if they're going to allow this, but I would like to see them happen. And then obviously when you first get in, you should be able to tab between, first party games or Nintendo published games and third party games and indies, however they want to organize it. I feel like that is an opportunity that should exist for other people who want to, have games in the Nintendo Switch. That way, I don't have to have 50 different apps for 50 different games in the Nintendo Switch. I could just have one app that has all the sub-applications underneath the layers. Plus, then it also means you would be allowing third parties and indie developers to use the other features of the Nintendo Switch Online app, which, starting at some point next year, people are going to be paying for. So again, if you're going to have a paid online system, you might as well allow third parties and indie developers to take full advantage of the system that you have in place. Now, Splatnet 2, obviously, the way that it works is not necessarily the way that every single sub app is going to work, because the sub apps are going to be catered to the games they're on. But there are a lot of things I like in it that I think Nintendo can already look into expanding for even games that are already on the Switch. And I'm not just talking about ARMS and Mario Kart 8 and Snipperclips. I'm talking about even non-multiplayer games, like Breath of the Wild, could actually benefit from this companion app idea. So in the sub app of Splatoon 2, you can order gear, which that initially I thought I was going to be bothered by the fact that there was exclusive gear on the app, but then after exploring the gear and exploring the stuff in game and taking a close look at it, there doesn't appear to be any competitive advantages to the gear you can get off of the Splatnet 2 sub application and the gear that you can just get through playing the game normally. So when you consider that, I'm not actually that upset about it. It's all about style. It's all about what you want to look. And anyways, if somebody else ordered and brought the gear in and they appear in your game, you can order it off their body anyway. So you don't really even have to use the app to potentially get the gear that's in the application itself. It's actually a really cool system in Splatoon 2 where you can, you know, order gear that other players have. The game is definitely not trying to prevent you from having gear. So I really like that. It just gives you a quick, easy, convenient way to do that, especially when you're not at home. You know, I bought a pair of really, what I think are some really kick-ass sandals, that some white, I mean, they're super fly in my opinion, that my character wears, and I think I have a hat coming right now. No, headphones. I got some headphones. I like them. I think, I don't know, it feels like it's something I wear. I wear sandals on a daily basis. I wear headphones on a daily basis. It just kind of feels like an embodiment of me. But again, you know, personal preferences here. So I really like that you can order the gear and that it's not overpowered and it fits right in with the game. And it's just something for me to do when I might not have Splatoon 2 or my Switch with me. I would like them to allow me to order more than one piece of gear at a time, however, because then it does feel like it's something that I need to have my Switch with me so I can continue to order gear. I think they should let you order one gear per set, or one piece of gear per set. So one headpiece, one pair of shoes, and one shirt. I think that's a limitation that's fine. So you can't just order an unlimited number of things because that kind of defeats the purpose of rotating items and all that stuff. But I think that's really good. What I also think is good is that it tracks your stats from like your most recent matches, which is great. You can go quickly look at, how many matches did I recently win? Was it ranked? Was it not ranked? Was it in, different forms of the game? Salmon Run, that's what I was thinking of. How did I perform at Salmon Run? You can see your score, how many people you splatted, etc. You can look at replays, quote-unquote replays, of your last match, which is really, really neat stuff. And of course, it gives you some fun and silly stats, like if you convert how much paint you have spread in the world of Splatoon to how much area in the actual world you would be covering with that same paint, it gives you like monuments and landmarks that you have covered, and then it actually tells you what the next landmark is for you and how much more paint you need to splat around to to cover that type of monument in the real world. It's a completely useless thing, but it's just really fun. And this is where I feel like a Breath of the Wild sub app would actually fit right in, where you could have a bunch of useless information that on its own doesn't really make the game better, but it makes the application and it makes the idea of a companion app a little more entertaining to me. You know, things like how many times have I died? What's the most common enemy type that I have faced? What boss do I happen to play against the most? What's the largest amount of damage my character has ever taken? You know, what's my favorite type of weapon, you know, between one-handers and two-handers, and, you know, and even maybe a way to organize that, where, like, if you eliminate the Master Sword, because the Master Sword has that advantage of, you know, doesn't permanently break, you know, what's my favorite item type? Is it one-handers, two-handers, boomerangs, bow, blah, 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 blah. Just a bunch of statistics and stats that really don't amount to mattering at the end of the end of the day, but it's just really entertaining to look at, and it's something that, you know, if I'm on the pod or if I'm, you know, at work, and I work from home, so obviously I don't necessarily need this kind of thing for at home, but just in general, you know, I'm on a drive, I'm out with my kids, or I'm watching them at the pool quick, and I just want to glance at my phone instead of checking Facebook. Let me check the companion app quick and see just some random stats from Breath of the Wild that can make for some fun conversation points with my friends. Just some ideas out there. And in general, I like this stuff that the Splatnet 2 is doing, and I would like to see them expand this again into all Nintendo games and hopefully third-party games and indies. Nintendo allows them to get on it too, because I like the sub-app within a main app that gives you a bunch of information and some things that can affect the game and some things that don't really affect the game at all, and things that affect the game don't actually break the game. Like, you don't feel like you're missing out without having it. But it's still fun to have it. It's not like Amiibos, where I feel like one thing they have done with Amiibo, and it's something I was always scared of, that they were going to lock content behind Amiibo, That you couldn't otherwise enjoy or could make a significant impact in a game. And outside of skins, I feel like there have been times where there has been like pieces of content locked behind Amiibo that I don't agree with. And I don't feel like there's anything locked behind Splatnet here, because you can go into Splatoon and get these items off of other characters. So it's not like it's impossible to get it within the game itself as it stands today. Now, moving beyond all that, because I think that's fantastic, I've obviously had some well-voiced criticisms of the app, and it's mostly to do with voice chat and the fact that right now, to use voice chat, it hijacks your phone. You cannot do anything else on your phone. You can't check notifications. You can't check text messages. You can't even let your phone fall asleep. You have to go change a setting on your phone to keep it all awake. And obviously, this causes several issues, you know, with the fact that no app should ever hijack your phone entirely to use. And on top of that, just the idea that you can't put it to sleep. When I did my own battery test, within 35 minutes, I lost 50% battery, starting at 100% with no other applications open and my phone on low light. Like, this is just mind-boggling to me that I can't put it in idle and continue to chat with my friends and, you know, check a text message while continuing to chat with my friends. Try to look up an online strategy on, you know, Google and not be able to keep talking to my friends. There's obviously some limitations with communications with friends that I don't like right now that I assume will be addressed. Like the fact that you can only chat with them when you're in the lobby before the start of a game. You can't chat with them outside of the game. There's no cross-game chat. There's no way for me to directly message either voice, you know, leave a voicemail for someone or text them, which I feel is really weird on a smart device. If you're going to have all of the online communication aspects, the voice chat and everything, happen on a smart device, then you should be able to take advantage of that smart device. Like, texting is highly popular. It's not going anywhere. And then when you have a smart device right in front of you, it just makes sense to be able to direct message people, maybe even have chats a la Discord or whatever with people through the app. I shouldn't have to use other means of communication to do that, especially since a lot of people that I have friends that I have friended on my Switch, I don't have their phone numbers. I don't have their Facebook contacts. Contact information. I honestly don't really have any other way to contact these people but through Nintendo's network. So, I mean, you could argue if you truly matter to me, I have your contact information, but it shouldn't be that complicated for me to send out a message to a bunch of people who I have friended and be like, hey, I want to get together a Mario Kart 8 tournament this weekend. Let's do it. So just throwing that out there as some functionality that is missing. And when you consider all those issues, I feel like they're all addressable. I feel like Nintendo might have messaging planned for the future. They might have cross-game chat and lobbies that you can make within the app as long as people are logged into their Nintendo account, but not necessarily have to be in a lobby to play a game, just like a general lobby like Discord and Ventrilo, you know, and all those other voice apps, even Skype, like just how it works. I feel like Nintendo can do this, and I feel like they might be doing that in 2018, but they need to address all the voice chat issues I've had. So in my world, the perfect app would allow all those companion apps with all that neat stuff that some of it's useful in-game, some of it's just pointless, but it's entertaining. And then on top of that, they would take all the issues that I currently have with voice chat and eliminate them. Now, the one aspect I haven't talked about yet, and it's the one thing that's bothered me the most about voice chat, because of the way I prefer to enjoy voice chat and game audio, is I prefer to have them come through the same pair of headphones. Now, there are multiple reasons for this. For starters, I do stream games online. And right now, what actually kind of sucks is that when I'm listening to the game audio coming through my TV, I can't actually also listen to notifications on my PC at the same time. So when you guys are subscribing, when you guys are doing this stuff, and I'm getting all the dings and everything, I can't actually hear that. And it sucks. And it's even worse when I'm using the voice chat on the phone because I can't just have the game volume come from the TV because it might reverberate back into the microphone, creating a really poor streaming experience. Now, obviously, this is just coming from a streamer's perspective. But let me just look at this from just a pure gamer's perspective. Forget first world problems with live streams and all that stuff. Just from a video game perspective and from my personal preference, I've been playing multiplayer online games for a long time. I was playing Age of Empires online over dial-up internet way back in the 90s on MSN Gaming Zone. I was, you know, there for Halo 1 on Xbox. You know, I even attempted to play Phantasy Star Online on the GameCube back in the day. I've been dealing with this online communications or lack of communication and voice chat and typing chat and all this stuff forever. And there's multiple ways to do it. And on a PC, it's obviously a little easier to type out stuff, you know, with a hotkey than, you know, while also voice chatting. It kind of depends on the situation. But personally, I've always preferred game audio and voice chat to come through the same headset. And this actually started for me back in 2004 with World of Warcraft. When I was using Ventrilo servers, or I think it was TeamSpeak back then we were using, I liked the idea of having the game audio and the voice chat coming through my one headset. That way I didn't have to worry about feedback. That was always something that bothered me with people who would say have their voice chat come through their headset, but then they have their game audio coming from their speakers on their computer, and you can hear that game audio reverberating back through the headset or through their microphone. So it would like really distort a lot of things coming from that person. Or on the other hand, if they had the game audio coming through the headphones and they had the voice chat coming through the speakers, you could hear other people talking. It creates this big echo effect, and it's not good. And you can hear this on consoles today. When I game on Xbox, there are times when I'm playing Madden especially that I know people are using their Kinect and their speakers from their TV to use their voice chat. And you could tell because there's a lot of feedback. Now, is it as bad as it possibly could be? No, but it's not good. It sounds distorted. Nothing sounds good. And then you have, even when people use the single earpiece headphones with one ear for the voice chat and then you listen to the TV, there are times, not all the time, but there are times, depending on the volume of their TV, I can hear the feedback from their game through their microphone that I sometimes confuse with the audio from my game, and it just creates a not good experience for gaming. It's not ideal. And I'm not saying you're someone that can't enjoy voice chat in that way. There are obviously millions of people that are just fine voice chatting that way. And so my issues with the game audio splicing from the Switch to the phone and back into your headset is not something that a lot of you are going to necessarily find as a problem, because you already only listen to your game audio from your TV or from the Switch locally anyways. But for me, I prefer to be able to have all of it come through one headset. And on Xbox One, they let me do that. On PlayStation 4, they let me do that. On PC, I've been doing that since at least 2004. So it's probably been possible way before that, because you're basically just having, instead of all the audio going through your speakers, coming through headphones. It's not that hard. But Nintendo lets me do it, but they let me do it in a very overcomplicated way. So one thing I would like to see in my perfect Nintendo Switch Online app is that Nintendo just gives me the option to do it the way I want, which is essentially they allow the Bluetooth from, or even Wi-Fi, but they preferably Bluetooth because it's a stronger connection between devices. I would prefer they allow the Bluetooth that does exist. There is a Bluetooth chip inside the Nintendo Switch. I would love to see it, if I have Bluetooth on my phone, be able to directly communicate to my phone, to my Nintendo Switch app, to send the audio signal there so I could just plug my headset into my phone and get the full audio experience. And then on top of that, and they need to have this in the app anyways, and this is another improvement for voice chat, they need to let me adjust individual people and individual volume levels for game audio and then people chatting on there, so I can adjust the levels to what I would like. Maybe even an option for when someone else is talking to me, reduce my game audio by 80% or whatever the case may be. And then when they stop talking, bring my audio levels back up, you know, in a gradual fashion that doesn't blow my ears out. And there's other things they need to improve with voice chat too. You can't mute individual people. You can only mute everyone. You can't increase the volume or decrease the volume on people, which if you know from voice chat, you need to do that sometimes because there's different, some people talk louder, some people have different quality microphones, some people just, they just in general create chaos, and you would like to just mute them temporarily, even if it's just a friend. It's kind of this crazy situation where the option for all this stuff should just be there. And I'm not saying that that should be the standard way that everything is set up, like out of the box. That's not how it needs to be. But the option to do it without a lot of hassle should be there. And it's not. So in my ideal world, everyone's happy. No one's left out in how they want to voice chat. And no one's left out. You could argue I'm not even left out. But I feel like I am overburdened to get voice chat the way I am when it doesn't have to be that way. And there a simpler way already exists, and Nintendo can do it. So They fix all this stuff. They bring it together. They give me those sub apps. They have that perfect voice chat capabilities. They allow direct messages and text messages and allow individual adjustments of all the different fine-tuned features of voice chat. Then I think we have an app that I am proud to use. And I know that's a lot of changes. It's a lot of additions. But it's also there. I feel like what we got to today, right, we can use right now. It's kind of that tip of the iceberg moment. It's where, yes, it's leaving a bad taste in my mouth, but it's not leaving one that can't be quickly remedied by something better. So I know a lot of people felt like I've been overreacting about this whole thing, but voice chat really, really does matter to me. I am that passionate about it because I am someone that does frequently use voice chat, and I know we can use Discord. I know we can use other applications, but I've always preferred to use the application that's most convenient for the system I am on. For a PC, Discord is most convenient. For my Xbox, Xbox Live is most convenient. So for Switch, shouldn't the Nintendo Switch Online app be most convenient since I'm already accessing it for other reasons? Just my humble opinion. And obviously in all of this, they can include surveys and bonuses and ways for you to do little things within the app itself to, you know, gain coins for My Nintendo to allow you to get more digital goodness. And if I'm honest, My Nintendo itself should be fully integrated into the app as well. So we don't have to go to our computers to go manage My Nintendo properly. I know we can do it through the web browser, but we can't use the app and do it through the web browser at the same time if we want to voice chat. So just throwing that out there. I'm very pleased with the way the app is set up with the sub apps. I just see there's still a long ways to go, and hopefully by 2018 my dreams come true and this is the perfect Nintendo Switch app for me. If you have your own ideas for the Nintendo Switch Online app, let me know down in the comments below. If you completely disagree with me and feel like all my ideas for the app are terrible, that is okay. Tell me what you would do differently, or if you would not do anything differently, tell me why the app is perfect for you right now. As always, I am Nathaniel Ruffeljantz from Nintendo Prime. If you like this video, you know what to do. If you dislike it, hit that dislike button. Otherwise, I will see you guys in the next one.